now 1.5 hours. Some guests stayed over the 2 hours. So after that, we're going to lunch over there, nearby the museum. Because this museum is still a little bit far from the city. So after lunch, we're going to visit the Winter Palace. So famous for the hot spring. So today, if we have time to get back to the city, we are going to visit in a museum of the stone tablets. So then, the hotel. That's our schedule today. Okay? Yeah, wait a moment. I will return the key cards here at the check room.
Is it 1 building?
Look at the run. You smell his breath?
Bad?
His breath.
Is it bad?
Oh.
It's from those greasy breakfasts.
Oh. His breath is stinking, man. Holy cow.
We should offer him a piece of gum, Zeebo.
Dallas? Your son should offer him a piece of gum. Seriously, like from a cigarette, some kind of chemical combination of everything. That one thing I noticed, like people here, they don't really care about like their, you know, their poor hygiene. You know? They don't trim their nose hair and they don't. I'm just bad, you know. Like, man, I gotta stick my head all the way over there. Yesterday was worse. This morning maybe, you know, he brushed like a little bit better than yesterday.
Something about the seats.
The seats.
Mind them, yeah. Here we go, baby. Now it's talking.
Cool. This one goes back.
What is that? You don't need a slide out.
Yeah, you don't want me any closer, right?
Oh, yeah. I need some distance. Back, you know, you slide that shoe down, it's going to come to my head.
Sitting on my brother's hip, man.
Sitting on your brother's mouth?
Hip. Yeah, right on his hip.
Boys!
Yeah.
See the run now.
That's
okay. Ah, Zhong Guo.
Where?
那个小李啊，小李。 那个遥控器，你还是想不起来。
Yeah, there's a lot of Asian people. They don't really care, you know, like they don't frost the teeth, you know, like their hair is sticking out. They eat garlic in here too.
That's fitting nicely.
Okay. Yesterday, when they first got into bars, man, I have to like lean all the way just past him. I mean, anybody smell his breath?
Yeah.
You smell it?
I was in the gondola with him.
Oh, you were in the gondola with him? Oh my god. How do you like that?
Hot, steamed like a garbage.
Like a Musashi! Spread like a Musashi!
See, that's also really short.
And also, the Chinese people are very
即係你知喺啲三藩線住咁耐，好多有機佬有船啊，好撚慢我噶嘛，遇到人咪好撚中意打膊頭啊，嚇咁樣摸下摸下咁，即係屌咁即係，哎呀唔知機又唔成，好似唔知咩咁啊嘛，啊真係。
Pen is broken. Pen is broken.
What's it?
Go ahead.
Huh?
In your same position.
我係大佬，即係個個人有翻咁嘅距離咁，講講咁黐到咁埋咁做乜嘢啫？咁啊真
係，仲要打打膊頭，好好壯，
係啊，哇，好大個心口咁，搞錯呢樣咁黐閪線嘅。
That we needed both when we get on.
We got no way to get on the
dollar. So when I got on, naturally I get on the gondola. I'm in
debt.
I was going to throw it. Then I said to myself, look, this is a good little souvenir. This is my part. We need a car. What the hell?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, how could you get there unless you got on?
I'm just hang low. You know, let's see if I can get it.
And that was the same thing. I noticed also, you know, it's almost such a thing. When Jeff had to check all his IDs, I think he's trying to get on. He tries to get on.
It's Astro.
專門喺個區啊，男女都係你，都係機
嘅。You know the main problem with the heaters is the heat rises, and the heaters are on the ceiling, so all the heat stays up there. You know? If the heater was on the floor, it would be a lot warmer. You know?
After the charges, I mean, the heater was on when I went in there.The bed was so darn cold that Basil said to me, do you want to go play some, to go bowl? I said, hell, I'm not leaving from this cold place to go in the cold and come back in the cold. So I had to go warm the bed up. This morning was all right when I got this morning. But we closed the door to the bathroom, so we opened the bathroom. Uh-oh.
It's freezing in there, yeah.
Okay, wait.
So the lady said, I gave her.And she gave it to Joe. So I'm done. I'm clean. They called. This woman is not that guilty, though. So they had to call her. She said that I gave it to her.
I remember you gave it to her.
But then she said she gave it to Joe.
And Joe doesn't
never
got
it, right? And Joe doesn't
have
it. Oh, Lord.
They tried to fucking rape you, basically. Took out every penny.
This place is, man, this place is a crap. I am not a complainer, you know me, right?
No, yeah.
Freaking bathroom was flooded inside number 10. And then...
In other bathroom, the toilet.
Well, all right, same thing. And then we went inside, the place is cold as shit. The remote for the thing doesn't work. I took out the battery from my palm pilot and put it in there. It still didn't work.
It's terrible, Jose.This is the best hotel they have in this town.
This is what I hear. This is what I hear.
It's like the most expensive, the best they have in town. It's freezing all night.
It's probably the only one they haven't told.
I was sitting in the bathroom earlier and I didn't get
them.
Yeah.
The best one, even the only one. What the hell, you know?
And she took that car. And I'm stuck in the dark.
Last night, they fucking, they took out, like, they shut down the whole building's electricity.
Yeah, because my building. We were in one room,
yeah, because they want to save electricity.
What your room?
No light or nothing. You walk out the door, I'm like, goddamn, it's dark as hell here.
So we had
all your building is only one room occupied. Like, I'm still somebody here. You gotta open the damn light in the hallway, you know, what the fuck?
Should give us a discount, not charge us for the towels.
Well, they didn't turn it back on.
No electricity, right?
No electricity. But because this is a mountain, you know? Just the hallway, there's no electricity.
It's just cold.
I mean, I was freaking out. Like, it's no, so dark, you can't see shit.
That's a little bit of...And it was then that they
didn't have the bathroom
was flooded and
you can't sue anybody.
When I stay inside,
it
was down to the 102.
Exactly. There's no liability. There's nobody suing.
Except that we are showing 102.
You fall down, you go to the hospital, you take care of yourself.
Yeah,
when you're in the shower,
you
close the whole floor.
That's why the lawyer is. The lawyer's occupation is not a popular doctor.
no money yet.
But it's still sweaty.
How much is that thing?
Can we close the door? Can we close the door?
They want to charge me a little fucking towel. I use a small little towel wipe from here. They want to charge my little towel for 10 yuan. I used a little face rag. I cleaned the mirrors. This is kind of foggy. Well, I mean, I don't know, but they say, well, there's different kind of dirties. You didn't use to wash your face. You use for cleaning something.
Oh, this was that day.
Yeah, no, so right here, right now. Here? I said, no, I'm not paying for it. Fuck yeah. They want to charge me 10 yuan for that fucking towel, that little towel. I'm like, I'm not paying for it.
Well, you remember it happened on my local lake last time, you know? One of those boys had to pay extra.
You know what? Because this place, they know you're not coming back. It's one shot deal. Everybody stay here, it's a one night stay. So they need to charge you. Like everything, as much as they got a little this, little that. I didn't touch anything. I mean, they have to do laundry anyway, the towel, but now they want to charge.
And what amazes me is so much ways that they can make money that they don't see. No postcards, no little gift items, you know.
No. Well, they're mountain peoples, you know.
We get laughed at.
Hello?
Is it Ron?
Who's this?
This is Mr. Azzaretti.
Who's it?
This is Roy Mercer. You don't know me. I got your name off a business card. It's on a bulletin board down to the grocery store. You're an investment feller.
Not me.
You don't do bonds and stocks and such?
No.
Well, by God, that's what information I got. What do you do?
Who is this?
Roy D. Mercer, M-E-R-C-E-R. I was calling about a project my boy Raymond had down there to the Jew College in his economic class.
I don't know. You got the wrong guy.
Well, what do you do?
I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out myself.
is an investment father. Do you not have nothing to do with that?
No, not at all.
Well, hell, somebody lied to me then, or you're lying to me now, because old boy answered the phone and started giggling right off the bat.
Hang on a second.
Well, no, I can't hang on a second. I need some investment information.
What do you need? I can see if I can help you out.
Well, there's some bond theft down there. My boy got a project down to the junior college. He's trying to pick bonds and such and follow them in the paper and see how they do and whoever makes the most money. You know, they get a new skateboard for Christmas. It's a brand new one of them Tony Roma skateboards down there.
Want to do what?
I don't know. It's one some kind of hot skateboard, Tony Roma or something like that.
Yeah, huh? Let me see if I can help you out, though. Hang on a second, right?
But I'd hate to, huh?
We got a bad connection.
Bad connection in my ass. I tell you what, I need some information on a bonder. I'm going to be down there and be on somebody like Stink on an Adam Sandler movie. That's going to be funny.
All right, buddy, hang on.
I hate you, buddy. I just called to call up for some investment information for my boy. You're going to give me...
Tell you what, man, your boy's in a lot of trouble if he's asking me for information.
I'm sorry?
He could be in a lot of trouble.
How about it? You're going to be in a lot of trouble. You keep smarting off like that to me.
Oh, yeah, big boy?
Yeah, by God. How about I come down there and kick your ass so hard you can cough and fart at the same time? You're going to be laughing out the other side of your face over there. I'm going to put a pot knot on your head big enough to need a support garment. I'll be on you like ugly on a Baldwin brother. But it ain't going to be funny. No, I tell you what, I'm trying to get some information on some daggone bonds.
Rocky!
I tell you what, your future is pretty rocky right now. Because I'm going to be on you like red ants on a spilt snow cone down there.
Wait a second. You're too smart to be Rocky Storm as who's this, Tommy?
You calling me dumb?
No.
Now, this is Roy Damn Mercer, the fella that's getting ready to dot both your eyes. How'd I get down there to where you're at? Get you laughing at and tell me how to get down there. Or when I find out, I won't be on you. I'm going to knock a lung loose. Are you there?
Yeah, man.
Well, listen, by God, how long has it been since you've had you smart ass whoop? It ain't nothing for me to whoop a Yankee's ass.
You must have a lot of time on your hands.
I tell you what, I'm trying to get a hold of an old boy to try to get some bond information. Then I got smart mouth. And hung up on it. Well, I tell you what, I just called an old buddy of mine I know give me some information. That's old Peter Dowden.
Who the hell is on the phone? phone? How many of you are on the phone?
Good God Almighty.
Fucking information is going to kill you.
How many folks I got to, how many asses I got to whoop up there?
Is this Ron?
Ron.
Who the hell is this? Well, quit whooping yourself first.
Ron, this is Phil and Brent and Roy D. Mercer calling you from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Really?
By God. We got put up to this by Peter Dilo. You know Peter?
Yeah, I do know Pete. How do you know Pete?
We don't know him at all.
We know his brother.
I thought so. You never been lit into by a Long Island Italian. It ain't pretty.
Here we go.
Long Island, I tell you.
Island, I tell you.
All right, it ain't nothing for me to whoop either one of them. Long Islander or an Italian.
I tell you what, you guys get out to golf for a little while.
Who is on the phone here?
Here's a couple of guys. You know what you call it? It's like a big trading desk, so everybody has access to the telephone.
What's the market doing today?
Who the hell knows? Since I'm talking to you, I haven't paid any attention.
Yeah.
Damon.
This Diamond?
Yeah.
Diamond, are you the farmer that's in charge of that really rock and roll thing? It's a band that Chris Dwart.
Yes, sir.
Everyone can hear? All right. Yeah. Okay. Well, they used to, your way of talking out here. I don't know. People don't call each other fellas out here. They call each other dudes. I don't know what you're talking about, but you sound like you're about to smart mouth. Well, I'm just trying to get some information about Chris Dwartz. He's a rock and roll fella played at the Gaines Ballroom in Tulsa.
Yes, sir.
Back on New Year's Eve.
Uh-huh.
He's in charge of that.
Yes, sir.
You're the fella that's getting ready to get his ass.
Who is this?
Or maybe you're the dude that's getting ready to get his ass. My name is Roy Mercer. My t-shirt went down there. That